Hello everyone and welcome back to Easy Dentistry, a channel that makes dental education incredibly easy and interesting. We have started uploading lectures on a highly requested important subject, that is oral pathology. You can find many lectures of oral pathology in our playlist. Today we are starting with a new chapter in oral pathology which is very important, that is diseases of the skin. This chapter may be known by the other name, vesiculobullous diseases. So, coming to the classification, there are variety of classification for the vesiculobullous diseases. Every university, every college follow different classifications. So, I recommend you all to refer the classification which is recommended by your university. An easy classification I will provide here is depending upon the etiology. The diseases of the skin or the vesiculobullous diseases are divided on the basis of the etiological agent as the first group genetic, those with a genetic cause. Example of such disease is epidermolysis bullosa. Second is the immunologic cause. Those diseases coming under immunologic cause are pemphigus, pemphigoid and bullous lichen planus. The infectious cause or the viral infection include herpes simplex, varicella zoster, hand foot mouth disease, herpangina and measles. And the miscellaneous include erythema multiforme. So this is one of the classification of vesiculobullous disease. I recommend you all to follow the classification which is accepted in your university. So coming to some of the basic terminology you should know about the skin lesions. What is a vesicle? A vesicle is a clear fluid filled lesion. It is present below the epithelium and it is less than 5 mm in diameter. What is a bulla? Bulla also contains clear fluid. It is also present below the epithelium and it is larger than 5 mm in diameter. So here in this diagram you can see the vesicle and bulla. The vesicle is smaller, that is less than 5 mm, and bulla is larger. It is more than 5 mm in diameter and both are present below the epithelium. Now, what is erosion? Erosion are red lesions caused by rupture of vesicle or bulla and they are mostly white. So, when the vesicles or bulla, they rupture, they leave behind red moist lesions called as erosions. Now, what is plaque? Plaque is a raised lesion. It is somewhat raised above the skin surface. It is greater than 1 centimeter. And sometimes the plaque are called as large papules. Now what is a nodule? Nodule is present in dermis or mucosa and it protrudes out and it is mostly dome shaped. So here you can see multiple nodules which are dome shaped and they are raised. Now what is a pustule? As the name indicates, a pustule contains pus. So it is a blister containing purulent yellow material. Now let us study the first disease of the skin, the ectodermal dysplasia. The other names of ectodermal dysplasia is hereditary ectodermal dysplasia and ectodermal dysplasia syndrome. Now we will be studying this disease under the following headings: introduction, genetic basis, the clinical features, oral manifestation, histologic features and the treatment of the disease. We will be studying two syndromes associated in ectodermal dysplasia. So coming to the introduction, ectodermal dysplasia is a large group of heterogeneous inherited disorders. The manifestation of ectodermal dysplasia is seen in ectodermal derivatives, that is those tissues which originate from the ectoderm show disorders or show disturbances in this ectodermal dysplasia. The ectodermal derivatives in the body present are skin, hair, nails, the eccrine glands and the teeth. So all these tissues which are derived from the ectoderm are affected. Now, the current classification of ectodermal dysplasia is dependent upon the clinical features. And the classification include congenital ectodermal dysplasia, diffuse ectodermal dysplasia and non-progressive ectodermal dysplasia. This group is made up of more than 150 syndromes. We will be studying hypohidrotic ectodermal dysplasia and hidrotic ectodermal dysplasia in detail. Now also remember that this ectodermal dysplasia is frequently associated with the mid-facial defect, mainly cleft lip and cleft palate. Now the etiology is aberrant development of the ectodermal derivatives. Now why this aberrant development of the ectodermal derivatives occur? This is because of the mutation of the genes. The X-linked hypohidrotic ectodermal dysplasia is most common and in which there is reduced expression of the EGFR or epidermal growth factor receptor, and the gene which is affected or mutated is ED1. Then autosomal recessive disorders, phenotypically indistinguishable from X-linked forms, exist in humans, and the candidate gene for the autosomal recessive kind of ectodermal dysplasia is the Downlys locus. Now, the hidrotic ectodermal dysplasia, also known as Clouston syndrome. Remember the other name for the hidrotic kind of ectodermal dysplasia, the Clouston syndrome. The gene which is affected is GJB6, and this GJB6, it encodes connexin 30. So also remember this gene which is affected, because it may be asked in your MCQs. The hidrotic type of ectodermal dysplasia is associated with GJB6 gene coding for connexin 30. Now, mutation of PVRL1 gene, which is a gene which encodes for the cell-to-cell adhesion molecule or the herpes virus receptor, have also been reported to be associated with ectodermal dysplasia, specifically associated with cleft lip and palate. So, PVRL1 gene is associated with ectodermal dysplasia with cleft lip and palate. Now coming to the clinical features, the features may be mild or devastating. Whites are most commonly affected. X-linked hypohidrotic dysplasia is mostly seen in males, and the females are just the carriers. They show no signs and symptoms. But the other kind of ectodermal dysplasia have no gender predilection. Only the hypohidrotic type is associated with males. Here is another important MCQ question. And no clinical symptoms can be seen in neonates. Now, when the newborn grows up, you can find the dental hair and nail manifestation. There is reduced number of hair follicles. The hair of the patient are sparse, or there may be complete absence of hair. The hair bulbs may be distorted or small or bifid. So here you can see the characteristic hair present in the patients with ectodermal dysplasia. The eccrine glands or the sweat glands are absent, or they may be sparse, or they may be rudimentary. So sweating does not occur in this patient. The mucus glands may be absent in the upper respiratory tract, bronchi, esophagus and duodenum. Dry mouth is a frequent feature which occurs due to hypoplasia of the salivary glands. Dry eyes is another important feature associated with hypoplasia of the lacrimal glands. So all the glands are hypoplastic. The sweat glands, the salivary glands, the lacrimal glands, all are hypoplastic in ectodermal dysplasia. The dental features, teeth show abnormal morphogenesis. So you can see abnormally shaped teeth. Sometimes the teeth may even be absent. The nails are brittle, they are thin, they show abnormal ridging and they may be deformed. So here you can see the characteristic nail features of ectodermal dysplasia. Other features include lack of breast development in these patients, deficient hearing, reduced vision, cleft lip and palate, and missing toes and fingers. The oral manifestation include anodontia or complete absence of teeth, oligodontia or partial absence of teeth. The jaw growth is not impaired. The teeth may be malformed. They may be truncated or cone-shaped. There, because of this absence of teeth or malformed teeth, the alveolar processes in these patients are underdeveloped, so there is reduction in the vertical dimension. So here you can see the characteristic dental features, malformed teeth in ectodermal dysplasia patient. The palate may be high arched. There may be presence of cleft in the palate. There is hypoplasia of the salivary glands leading to xerostomia, protuberant lips, and the characteristic pseudoragates are present in ectodermal dysplasia. So here you can see the protuberant lips and the pseudoragates or deep fissures present on the lips. There may be hypoplasia of the nasal and the pharyngeal mucous glands as well, leading to rhinitis, pharyngitis, dysphagia, and hoarseness. Now, let us study two important syndromes in this heterogeneous large group of ectodermal dysplasia. First, the hypohidrotic ectodermal dysplasia or anhidrotic ectodermal dysplasia, which is known by another name, Christ-Siemens-Torrance syndrome. So remember this alternative name for this hypohidrotic ectodermal dysplasia. As the name suggests, there is hypohydration, that is reduced hydration. The sweating in this patient is reduced. Now, this hypohidrotic kind of ectodermal dysplasia is the most common. It is inherited. It is inherited by X-linked recessive trait. There is hypohidrosis in this patient, that is reduced sweating. There is anomalous dentition, onychodysplasia, hypotrichosis or reduced number of hair. And there is typical facial features which include frontal bossing, sunken cheeks, saddle nose, thick everted lips. There is wrinkling and darkening of the skin around the eyes and large low set ears. These are the features, the typical features of hypohidrotic ectodermal dysplasia, the frontal bossing, protuberant lips, absence of teeth, and the nails showing anomaly. Then these features are not obvious at birth, so diagnosis at neonatal period is very difficult, and it can be done only by two features, that is unexplained pyrexia and extensive peeling of skin. As we have already discussed, in hypohidrotic ectodermal dysplasia, there is reduction in sweating. So, it is very difficult to maintain the body temperature. So, these patients have pyrexia or fever, and there is extensive peeling of the skin. The dental manifestation include conical or the peg teeth, hypodontia, anodontia, and delayed eruption of teeth. Other features of hypohidrotic ectodermal dysplasia include atopic eczema, short stature, eye defects, dryness of the eyes, photophobia, but also note that the intelligence level of the patient is normal. Now, the second syndrome is the hydrotic ectodermal dysplasia, known by the other name Clouston syndrome. It is inherited as an autosomal dominant trait. The homozygous state is lethal. The gene affected is GJB6 gene, which encodes the protein connexin. Clinical features include nail dystrophy, hair defects, and palmoplantar keratosis. The nails may be thickened, discolored, and having paronychial infections. They are very prone to infection. The scalp hair are sparse. They are fine, they are brittle, and the eyebrows in these patients may be thin or absent. There is the facial features in this hydrotic kind of ectodermal dysplasia is normal. Also, remember here that the hydrotic ectodermal dysplasia patients show normal sweating. There is no specific dental defects. The histology in these patients, you can see in the lesions, reduced number of sweat glands, reduced number of hair follicles, reduced number of sebaceous glands. In hypohidrotic ectodermal dysplasia, the epidermis is thin and flat. The eccrine glands are poorly developed. There is reduced number of mucous glands, and the salivary gland ducts shows inflammatory changes. Now the treatment. A no specific treatment, dental evaluation and intervention. The patient may be required to use dentures right from the age of 2 years. The next lecture will be on chondroectodermal dysplasia. I hope you like this lecture on hereditary ectodermal dysplasia. Please subscribe to our channel. That's all for now. Happy studying.